see my this thing?
Yes, recording started, ma'am.
I know, but can you see my slide?
Yes, we can see.
Yes.
Okay, that is what I'm asking. Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, so we continue with lesson number 3, synthetic fibers and plastics. So far we have finished synthetic fibers, now we are coming to plastics. Let's see what plastic is all about. Read better.
Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. All plastics do not have the same type of...
I will ask you to stop. All Sahil, I will not allow you to continue. Read properly,
plastic
please.
Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. All plastics do not have all same type of arrangement of units. In some, it is linear, whereas in other, it is cross-line plastic article. Available
is
in all possible.
Just a moment, Sahil. What are you doing? Sahil, what are you doing, beta? Is this the way to read? You're not stopping in the full stop. There's no intonation. You're just going from beginning to end, just like that, flat. No. I'm not able to follow you. How are your colleagues going to follow you, beta? I told you, go slowly, don't rush. That's the first thing that you have to understand. Then you're not using the punctuations properly.
Ma'am, I read?
No, Sahil will read. Do it again. Sahil, you will read after me. Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. Did you understand what I said? Sahil. Is he there? Sahil, are you there, beta? Boys, can you hear me? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, is he there? Sahil, is
yes.
Yes. Now read like me. Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber.
All plastics do not have the same type of arrangement units.
Of units.
In some it is linear. Of units. In some it is linear, whereas in other it is cross-line.
Linked.
Plastic articles are available in all possible shapes and sizes.
Okay. Are you going for a 100-meter race? Yes, Sahil? Do you have to catch a bus or something like that? Now, what is plastic? That is also a polymer, that polymer that we have already studied, like synthetic fiber. Now, they don't have the same type of arrangement of units. What are the units? Monomers, remember that. Somewhere it is linear. What is the meaning of linear, beta? One line. Whereas in others it is cross-linked, like this. Is it clear? This is called as cross-linked. And we can see so many plastic articles around us in different shapes and sizes. See over here, the first one is linear. Can you see this straight line? What is this one, beta? Linear. Understood? Hello? Hello?
Yes.
And the second one is cross-linked. Can you see that it's linked with each other? This is cross-linked. All of you understood? So this is the arrangements due to which types of plastics are differentiated. Same way, A1A is showing linear polymer. This one. A is showing linear polymer. Okay. Then B is showing branched polymer. This is B. It is showing branched polymer. And C is showing cross-linked polymer. Got it now? saw the differences in linear, branched, and cross-linked. Understood? Boys, can you hear me? First of all, tell me, beta. Can you hear me properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Then why don't you answer? Now you can see examples of plus. You are still young. You used to play with these alphabets. Then these are the cans. Can you see this? They are the baskets, toothbrushes. Then these are all the bottles, cans. Everything is made up of plastics. Some more. We have plastic milk and juice bottles. Then we have plastic lumber, that's decking docks, etc. Then we have play sets, bottles. Then we have plastic detergent bottles, buckets, containers, frisbees. You know what are frisbees? Don't you play with frisbees, Vita?
You play yes.
Frisbees? Okay. Yes. Then we have stadium seats. In the stadium, the chairs that we have, the attached chairs, those are also made up of plastics. Yes, now something more about plastic we are going to learn. Yes, who will read?
Then I read.
Okay. Who is that?
Sufyan.
Take Sufyan, right? Okay. But read properly. Louder. So that I don't have to ask you again. Start.
Plastic. The fact that it's plastic. The fact is that plastic is easily moldable. That is, can be shaped in any form. Plastic can be recycled, reused, colored, melted, rolled into sheets, or made into wires. That is why it finds such a variety of uses.
Do you agree? All of you agree with her?
Yes.
The truth. What is the meaning of fact? The truth that plastic you can mold. What is the meaning of molding? That you can give, you can change it into any shape. That is called mold. That means I can melt it and can give a shape. That is called as molding. So it can be shaped in any form. The best part of plastic is that you can recycle it. Again, you can use it. You can color it. You can melt it. You can roll it into sheets. Or you can draw it into wires. That's why we are using plastic in such a manner. Everywhere you see around yourself, you can see plastic material, isn't it? These are the examples. You can see the chairs, the buckets, the toys, the pots. Everything is generally made up of plastics these days. Have you understood? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Some more. Yes, read. Start to read. Hello?
Vyan.
Anyone? See, I want all of you to take part. It's not only Sahil and Sufyan will read. Every one of you will read.
Okay, ma'am. I read Sindraj.
Yes.
When we...
You have to give your name and start reading.
Read Sufyan. When we add hot water to a plastic bottle, it gets deformed. Such plastic will get deformed easily on heating and then bend easily are known as thermoplastics. Polythene and PVC are some of the examples of thermoplastics.
Thank you. Now, for example, we take a type of plastic, right? XYZ. We take plastic and we are adding hot water to it, right? What happens? It changes shape, that means it gets deformed. Now, these plastic which gets deformed on heating, and you can bend it very easily. They are known as thermoplastics. What are they? Thermoplastics, which can be deformed on heating, are called as thermoplastics. What are the examples? Polythene and PVC. What is the meaning of PVC, beta? Polyvinyl chloride.
The full
form of PVC is polyvinyl chloride. These are the types of the examples of thermoplastics. So this is how you have to remember. You have to learn it. The names of the thermoplastics. What are they, beta? Polythene and PVC. And what is the full form of PVC? Polyvinyl chloride. Is it clear, boys?
Yes.
We are going to see types of plastics. What are types of plastics? One is, just now what we read was thermoplastics, right, beta? Which can be
thermoplastic, plastic.
Which bends when it is heated, which can be molded when it is heated, that is thermoplastics. And other one is thermosetting plastic, which does not bend while heating, that is called as thermosetting plastics. Now we are going to work on thermoplastic we have done, now we are going to work on thermosetting plastics. Yes, read better.
Thermosetting plastic. Thermoplastic are hard and
properly, Sanraj.
Yes, ma'am.
Thermoset. If you miss out certain words, the meaning changes, beta.
Okay.
If you miss out certain alphabets, it's of no use. So you have to be very particular while reading. Read out.
Thermoset plastics are hard and rigid. Example is backlight and melamine.
When I'm saying something, if you can hear properly, you repeat after me. Is it understandable?
Yeah.
Okay. So thermoset plastics, they are very hard and they are very tough. What is the example? Bakelite and melamine. You know melamine dishes that you have at home, hard plastic dishes, beautiful color, colorful, looks good and easy to wash. Have you heard of melamine cookwares? You ask your mother, she may help you. So you can have a look at melamine dishes, okay? Melamine sets. Next.
Okay. Thermoset can be molded to set it in any shape, but it cannot be remolded.
Say it again.
Remolded.
Thank you. Good. Now this thermoset, you can mold it, but once you give it any shape, you cannot again remold it. That is the disadvantage, rather. That's the difference between the thermoplastic and the thermoset plastic, that thermoplastics can be molded while heating, whereas thermoset, once molded, you cannot remold it again. That means you cannot melt it again. Next. Next. Continue.
Okay. It is dark in color. Hard and resistant to heat and resistant to heat and electricity.
Generally, these type of thermosetting plastics, they are very hard. I mean, they are very dark in color. Oh.
Yes.
They are resistant to heat. That means nothing happens. If electricity passes through it, nothing happens if you heat it. Okay? Next.
Okay. It is being widely used for the handle of kettles and pans.
Peter, you have to improve. Sanraj.
Yes, ma'am.
Start practicing. What do you have to practice? Reading.
Okay.
5 minutes, every day 5 minutes you will read on your own, loudly. Not in your mind, but loudly. You will speak up. That is 5 minutes, okay. I said that is one chapter you can finish it. 3 to 4 pages you can finish it. Is it clear? Every day, without fail, you will read. You need to improve in reading better. So it is being widely used. That's the reason why, because it is resistant to heat. Now you got a cooker, right, Bita? You have seen a cooker at home? Mama cooks,
yes,
dal and bhat in that. Okay. Now the rest is made of aluminium metal. What is the metal? Aluminium. You know that, right? Silver color aluminium metal. But the handle is black. That is thermoset plastic. Do you understand? Now I can hold the handle without being burnt. Why? Because it is resistant to heat. The heat is not traveling from the metal to the thermoset plastics. Do you understand? So I can hold the cooker with the help of handle. Next.
Okay, ma'am. Earlier black telephone sets, electric switches, electric lamp holders, pins and plugs were made from thermoset plastic.
One thing is that, Sandras, you are pausing in between the words. There's a first thing that you have to understand, that you are not supposed to pause in between the words. Earlier, black telephone sets, electric switches, electric lamp holders, pins and plugs were made from thermoset plastic. This is how you have to continue. Am I clear, Sanraj?
Yes.
Second, you are repeating. For example, you say once electric switches, again you are saying switches. Why? The second thing that you have to improve, no repetition. It's not for Sandra's better. Class 8 is for all of you. Are you getting my point, better? 8 standard? Hello?
Yes.
8 standard. I'm telling to all of you. It's not Sandra's. I'm addressing
yes,
you
8 ma'am.
Standard. This is how you have to improve. This is how you have to improve. Okay?
Okay.
Now, we had these black telephone sets earlier, remember that? Big ones with the receiver and the holders. Then we had electric switches made up of black color. Electric lamp holders, again black switches. Pins and plugs were used to be black. They used to be from thermoset plastics, remember that? Nowadays, we are not using them, we are using the white. Yes. Now, what is the Bakelite? It's a type of thermoset plastic, isn't it? There you can see Bakelite here. It is a type of thermoset plastics. So now we are going to learn more about Bakelite. Please read better. Yes.
Bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. It is used for making I am Sandraj.
Sandraj, you have already read one slide.
Okay.
Let it go to someone else. Okay. Who wants to read?
Sufyan.
Sufyan, Sandraj, Sahil. Is there any fourth who wishes to read with her? Okay, one by one now. Sufyan will read, then Sahil, then Sandraj. Is it clear? What do you say? Hello?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Ali Reza.
Okay, Ali Reza, if you wish to, I don't mind at all. Yes, beta.
Backlight is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. It is used for making electrical switches, handles of various
utensils. Good. Well done. So what is backlight? It's a poor conductor of heat. That means the heat does not pass through it. And also electricity also cannot pass through it. What are we using for? We are using for making electrical switches and handles of utensils. Now we come to melamine. Yes, read. Yes, Ali, does the read.
Melamine is a
versatile
material. It is resists fire and can
tolerate
heat better than other plastics. It is used for making floor tiles, kitchenware, fabric which resists fire.
Thank you. Now what is melamine? Melamine is versatile, that means we can use it for many purposes, that's why it is versatile. This also resists fire and can tolerate heat as compared to other plastics. Where are we using it? We are using to make the tiles, the floor tiles, even the kitchen utensils, kitchenware, and even fabrics. What is the meaning of fabrics? Clothes, which resist fire. So the firemen, they wear the clothes where melamine is used. This is what I'm talking about. This is melamine. Can you see this? Can you see this, Bita? This is melamine.
Yes.
The kitchen wares, okay? So these are the properties that you have to learn by heart. Now fine, we are using melamine. It's okay, it's beautiful to look at and it's very easy to use. You can wash it properly and everything is good. But we have to be very alert because it produces cancer as well. So, read better.
If you eat in a melamine...
Adiraza, stop now. Two slices you have done. Now, Sufyan, then Sahil, then Sunraj, and then Ali Reza. Four of you, one by one, will read, okay? Okay, Sufyan, start.
Yes, ma'am.
No, Sufyan will read.
If you eat a melamine plate, you may become a victim of melamine cancer. Melamine is a thermosetting plastic and non-biodegradable. While eating, when we scratch the plate with a spoon, the melamine coating also goes into our body, which may cause cancer. Check under your plate whether melamine may be victim or not. Use bone china, glass or split plate instead.
You understand now? When are we eating on melamine dishes? So while if you are eating with your hand, no problem. But if you are using spoon or fork, then yes, the melamine coating is crushed and it comes off with the food in your body. And there is a probability that it can develop cancer in your body. So you have to check whether it is made by melamine or not. Or why to create a problem? Why to take a chance? So instead they are saying that use bone china, glass plates or steel plates. You understand? Instead of taking melamine, use bone china, glass plates or steel plates. Is it understandable? Is it understandable to all of you?
Yes.
This is how it looks like. So can you see the plates over here? These are all melamine. Now examples of thermoset. So just thermoset. Okay. So now we are going to read examples of thermoset plastics. What are they? Thermoset handles. A fire uniform is coated with thermoset plastics so to make it fire resistant. We have melamine bears and we have electric pin. You know that socket, it goes in the socket, that electric pin is always black. So these are all made up of thermoset plastics. Can you see over here? The handle, the thermoset handles. Can you see this thermoset handles? Then we have the fireman uniform. Then we have the melamine plates. Can you see this? Melamine plates. Then we have the switches. These are all thermoset plastics. Now we are going to work on thermoplastics. Is it clear with you, people, regarding thermoset plastics, Vita?
Yes.
Yes.
All of you? All of you understood thermoset? Then only we start with thermoplastics. Any problem regarding thermoset plastics, Vita?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? Okay. Yes. Now we start with thermoplastics. Start. Sahil? Sahil, is he there?
Thermoplastics are soft and flexible.
Okay.
They are.
Then? Continue better.
Are not elastic. Thermoplastics are soft and flexible. They are not elastic like rubber and steel. And steel springs. They melt in warming and regain their shape on cooling. Thermoplastics can be drawn into fine fibers, mold into any desired shape to stretch or spread a sheet. Some of the better known thermoplastics are nylon, polyamide, polyester, polyethylene, polyvinyl, chloride, PVC, acrylic, polyurethane, polypropylene, polytetrafluoroethylene, etc.
Very good. Good. Thank you, Uta. These are all extra information. Many of that are extra information for you. What we saw in thermosetting plastics, Uta, they were rigid. Right? Here what we find, they are soft and flexible, the thermoplastics. But remember, they are not so elastic like rubber. They are soft, no doubt, but they are not elastic. Whenever you give them heat, it melts. And again, when it cools, it gets the shape back. You can draw it into wires. You can give it any type of shape that you wish. And you can even make it as a sheet. The examples are nylon, which actually chemically is known as polyamide. We have polyesters, we have polyethylene, that is polypet vessels. Then we have PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride. We have acrylic and etc. So you don't have to go through the rest of the things because they are quite difficult for you to understand or to remember. Till acrylic, you remember. Is it clear? Boys?
Yes.
Is it clear, Vita? All of you? So these are the properties of thermoplastics. Same way we're going to learn. The thermoplastic examples are the plastic table and chairs. We have the plastic food containers. We have the toys. We have plastic spoons and fork. We have plastic cups. All. And the daily use items, you can see over here, the daily use items, the glass and the bottles. These are the daily use items. They are all made up of thermoplastic. Now, in general, what exactly is the properties of plastic? So, thermoplastic is over. Do you want to ask me any question? Boys, do you want to ask me any question, Vita? Any doubt?
No.
Any problem? Okay. Now, in general category, we are taking the properties of plastics. Read better. Who will read now? Sanraj. Beta, make it first. No, Sanraj will read.
Properties of plastic.
That means it stops. It stops. It does not allow. That is resist. Okay? Yes, Sanraj. Sophia, did you understand? Sophia, did you understand the meaning of resist?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sanraj, continue with her.
Properties of plastic. Resists corrosion.
Resist.
High temperature.
Resist.
What, ma'am?
I'm saying something, Sanraj. You have to repeat. Cannot go ahead. When I'm stopping you, I said resist. That means you have to repeat resist. Is it clear?
Yes.
Why am I saying so? Not for myself. I'm doing it for you. Read it again. Resist corrosion. Resist high temperatures.
Corrosion. Resist high temperature. Insulate heat and electricity.
Then?
Elastic. Thermoplastic can be recycled, not reactive to chemicals.
Reactive.
Reacting to chemicals and water. Water resistant. Soft. When hot.
Now, resist corrosion. That means, you know what is the meaning of corrosion, beta? Have you seen iron? Have you seen iron, beta? Iron? Iron pins. It becomes red. It becomes orange. It becomes powder. When you touch it, you get that orange powder on your hands. In the Gujarati, we can call it as cart lagi gaya, cart, iron stuff, almiras, cart. Have you heard of this? Yes, you get that orange powder coming out, and there is a hole in the. It becomes powdery, and if you do not paint it, there's a reason that why we paint the iron articles. If you don't paint it, then there is a hole. Generally, you get in the fridge. On the fridge, also you get it. You get it on the almira, those brown patches, that is called as rust. So that is corrosion. The phenomena is called as corrosion. Formation of rust is known as corrosion. So this plastic, it does not have any corrosion. So nothing goes wrong with plastic. There's no hole. It remains the same as it was. Then high temperature, that means it may not melt. Insulate, that means it is a bad conductor of heat and electricity. Nothing happens if I give heat, nothing happens if I allow the electricity to pass through it, nothing happens. It is elastic. And the thermoplastic, the type of plastic that we are talking about, thermoplastic, you can recycle, you can remold. Also, if you apply any chemicals onto the plastic, it does not react with it. And also, there's no reaction. You can store water in the plastic. So it does not react. So it is water resistant. And when you heat it, it gets molded, so it is soft. So these are the properties of plastics. Now, what does this mean? Plastics as material of choice, beta? Now, if I ask you, take a paper bag and take a plastic bag, which bag will you take to carry?
Paper bag.
Okay, paper bag. But why? Okay, give me an answer why. I'm talking the convenience. I'm not talking about that what you should do as a citizen. I'm just talking about the convenience. Which is convenient? Paper bag is convenient or plastic bag is convenient? Can you fold the paper bag?
No. Is convenient.
If you fold the paper bag,